love to also, you know, hear more about polling power.
Yes.
And how you actually leverage polling power and the framework, which, as we know, is about how do you propel yourself and others while managing what matters. So really staying focused, right, on what matters at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. And I'd really love to hear from your perspective, how did you leverage polling power in your transition from what you were doing a year ago to what you're doing now?
So I think when I think of polling power, as I was going through sort of the list, everything from priorities to opportunities to networking to leadership, all of those really played a part in where I am now and using those tools to really kind of get clear on what I needed to do next. So when you ask me which of the polling powers sort of did I use, it's really the answer is everything. You know, starting with priorities, I think that was the first, because again, going back to having a vision that you're ready for a change in your life or a change in your career can be a bit overwhelming.
Yes,
and it was certainly overwhelming for me.
Indeed.
And I think that I had to step back and not say, oh, I got to jump into this head first. And I have to just I have to look at everything that comes my way. Really taking the time and really through the tools in the workshop, understanding what priorities mean. And it's not about just what sounds the coolest or what seems really like a great idea. If it doesn't align with, you know, in my case, it was probably five different criteria that I had in terms of what was going to be a good fit for me. If it didn't align with that, then it's not a priority.
So Janae, really would love to go through with you specifically your polling power matrix, mm-hmm. and really how, you know, you stack up in terms of where you are today with polling power. So, you know, how is your polling power index? So why don't we go ahead and we'll actually lead everyone through this exercise. I think this will be really helpful in helping people to figure out their own polling power.
Great.
So, yeah. So in your particular situation, let's talk about overall, do you feel that you are persevering for your priorities and passions and your vision for your authentic self?
110%.
All right, so go ahead and check off that box. Overall, do you feel that you are meeting your obligations in terms of what you're accountable for and who you're accountable for?
Yes.
Go ahead and check off that box. Great. Overall, do you feel that what you're doing is worthwhile in terms of the impact that you're seeking?
Absolutely.
Go ahead and check off that box. Is what you're doing energizing you to make the juggling act sustainable?
Every day.
Yes. And do you have the resources to do what it is that you're doing?
Yes.
Let's check off that box. Great. So, Janae, in terms of others, can we talk about how you feel that you're helping others? First of all, do you feel that you are helping others?
When I think about where I am in my career, I've been doing this for 20 years. One of the things, again, going back to what inspires me, is working with young people. So I spent a lot of time, even as I was transitioning out of my previous job, I spent a lot of time working with, whether it's somebody just coming out of college or somebody just coming out of grad school, mm-hmm. I spent a lot of time mentoring. I also did a lot of work with some universities, guest lecturing. I love to watch people learn because I always put myself back in that position 20 years ago. And I had some really amazing, not just mentors, but advisors, coaches, friends, you know, people that helped me from the very first job that I had in sports, helped me to really be where I am today. So I think about that a lot. I spend a lot of time doing that. That's kind of where I like to put my focus and my priorities.
Great. So it seems that you are helping others, and is this way, your way of helping others align with your priorities then?
Yes.
And if so, feel free to check that box. Are you still able to meet your obligations by helping others in the way that you've been doing?
Yes, that's pretty easy for me since I know that my obligations and one of the things that I'm here to do is really to help others, so it goes hand in hand.
Great. So you were able to check off the box under obligations. So in this way of helping others, do you feel that it's actually worthwhile in terms of the impact?
Yes, it's the thing that probably drives me more than anything, so yes.
Great. So go ahead and check off that box. Mm-hmm. And it clearly seems as though it energizes you as well.
Yes.
So go ahead and check that off. And do you have the resources to help others in this way?
I wish I had more time in the day, but other than that, yes.
Great. Go ahead and check that off. So Janae, do you feel that you are, just moving on to the next row, do you feel that you are leading in terms of being proactive and driving change and action?
Yes.
How so? Can you talk about that?
I think when I think about things that work for me and the tools that I've used to kind of get to where I am now, I love to share that with other people because I think a lot of time we spend just focusing on what's the next step, without thinking about how to get there. So I've shared my journey with several of my friends, some of my colleagues, and I think that helps to sort of helps people think about it in a different way.
Okay, great. So you are leading, and that's aligned with your priorities. Your obligations, are you still able to meet your obligations?
Yes.
Go ahead and check that off. Is that way of leading actually worthwhile in terms of the impact?
Yes, it is.
Go ahead and check it off. And does it energize you?
Very much.
And do you have the resources to lead this way?
Yes.
Very good. This is amazing. And so, Janae, do you feel that you're also inspiring? And if so, how do you feel you're inspiring?
I would say inspiring and am inspired. So when I think about, again, going back to what really drives me and what energizes me, so if I can work with some of the advisory work that I was doing before this role, I started working with early stage startups. Everyone is really, really excited in those early stages, and there's so much energy, especially a place like New York, where it's just, you know, brimming with that kind of energy. I get really excited about that. And when I was able to sit down with some of these companies and help them refine their thinking and look at it from a different angle, you know, because when you're in it and when you're building the product, all you can see is the product. Taking a step back and looking at how are you marketing? How are you thinking about, you know, the bigger picture? How are you thinking about this from a strategic standpoint? That's what I had been doing with many of the startups. So I just loved that.
So you are very much inspiring. And so let's go back to this matrix. As you're inspiring, is that aligned with your priorities? Yes. Obligations?
Yes.
Are you meeting your obligations?
Yes.
Is it worthwhile in terms of impact?
Yes.
Are you energized by it?
Very much.
And do you have the resources to do it?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's perfect. Networking. So do you feel that you're networking? And if so, how?
Yes, I have reached out to my entire network, it feels like, in the last 2 years that I've been back here. I think one of the things for me, I was gone. I was in London for 7 years. So being out of the typical network, not just in the sports industry, but just in every area of my life, I was very conscious that I needed to rebuild my network when I got back here. So I'd say the last 2 years, I've spent really reactivating not just my sports network, but the media network, a lot of my Stanford network. I had people, you know, who were friends or who, now that I'm working, I'm on the Stanford board, people on the board. I've just been surprised at how open and accommodating people have been. Really helping with anything and any part of what I was looking for. I didn't really even need to articulate my vision that clearly because so many people were helping me do that, that by the time I actually did, it was even easier to reach out to a broader network. So I have tapped every single part of every network that I know.
That's amazing. So you've really been focused on establishing, building and leveraging your relationships.
Very much.
That's awesome. So how does it align with your power? I think you've got the hang of it. So aligned with your priorities, how about your obligations?
Yes.
Is worthwhile?
Very.
Energize you?
Yes.
You have the resources to do it?
Yes.
Excellent. And grow. This is a big one. And so do you feel that you are growing, Janae, in terms of developing personally and in other ways?
Yes, I feel like I've grown more in probably the last few years than I have in you know, in the early parts of my career. And I think one of the reasons is because I feel like when you're on that just sort of wheel and you're just going and going and going, which happens a lot, and you don't step back and you don't take time to actually look at where you've been and look at where you are now, it's very difficult to think about where you want to go next. So I spend a lot of time now just appreciating the moment and just being in the moment and saying, this is actually where I want to be right now. Where I want to be next, we'll figure that out. But I feel like what has really helped me grow is just appreciating the now and stop thinking about the past and the future.
Wow. And so going back to the Pulling Power Matrix, so is your way of growing aligned with your priorities, your obligations, what's worthwhile, your energy, yes, and your resources?
Yes, 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 and yes.
You're amazing. I'm very, very, very impressed that you were able to check off every single box, mm-hmm, which means that your polling power index is 100 because you were able to check off 100% of the boxes. And that means that you feel that you are propelling yourself and others while managing what matters. Do you feel that overall, that that is a correct statement?
Yes. I love the idea of managing what matters. Get rid of everything else and just focus on what matters.
Fantastic.